killing it. You're not gonna have me in my feelings tonight. No, you're not. Y'all not gonna have me in stitches tonight. Y'all gonna have tonight. No. Oh my God. Hey, you guys. Hi. How are you? And how are you? How are you? All the way in the back over there. As you guys know, it is me, D, and I'm back at it again for a TV talk. And today we are going to watch The Masked Singer, the quarter finale. I'm excited for this. Five masked singers are left. It's the Frog, the Night Angel, Kitty, Rhino, and Turtle. I honestly think Rhino is going home, unfortunately. Once is not the last, the previous four that I mentioned. Rhino, I like Rhino, but he's not my favorite. I don't see Turtle leaving, and he's starting to become one of my favorites as well. But as you guys know, I'm here for the Night Angel. Night Angel and Frog are my two favorites. As well, no, Night Angel, Frog, and Kitty. Oh my God. I want Kitty to step up her game though, definitely, because I believe for the past two nights she wasn't the strongest. But to be honest, the strongest is that Turtle. And I believe either it's going to be the Turtle or the Night Angel. I keep saying it. But anyway, how was your diet, your guys' day today? My Wednesday was pretty dope. I've actually posted a video before this one. And it's a music reaction, and it's for one of my favorite groups that are out right now. They started out on YouTube as well. They're called Cerati, and the song in the video was called Tear It Up. So watch it out. Watch it up. Maybe you want to tear it up. Maybe you like the song. So check out for that review as well, all right? So, yeah, without further ado, recap from last week. The who went home last week was the astronaut. He's good. Hunter in it was Hunter Hayes. He was good. So let's get into this one. The guest judge last week was his face, Gordon Ramsay. But without further ado, let's get into the Masked Singer for tonight. I do not know who this is. Who's the guest? Who is texting me? Y'all know I'm gonna say the Frog is Bow Wow, and he does have a child, so it's Bow Wow. Everybody cut Footloose. It's gonna do Footloose? That's gonna be sick. Oh, the crowd love you. No, not Busta Move. Listen, Frog is killing it. Frog is killing it. Frog ain't going nowhere but to the finals. That's where he going. It's a play.
I challenge you to figure out what this plane is all.
Y'all remember when he was on the plane and we thought Baba was on, but he tried to trick us and say he was on right? He tried to trick us and say that he was on first class or he was on a jet. And he was not.
Private jets.
Yeah, me. He didn't. He wasn't on a private jet. He tried to trick y'all and say he was on a private jet. That's the clue.
There was a thing with Bow Wow. The private jet.
Yes, Robin, you're right. I just said, Robin, why are you taking my answer?
Yeah.
So y'all see the shrimp? How it's curried and stuff. Listen, oh, and plus, what else I put new in here? So mom's made quinoa rice for herself, and I took the rest of it and put it in here. I mean, I took her food, but it's delicious. So, definitely, you could see that in there, the rice and the shrimp and the mango. I keep forgetting. But if y'all want me to do like a cooking video, like a cooking live, hit me, you know. Smash my comment section. Kill it. Destroy it. Murder. Kitty's up next.
Great job.
Kitty, I hope you do well. Kitty, I want Kitty to do better. She's a good singer, but she ain't as good as the tiger. She ain't as good as the turtle.
Incredible experiences. I also felt good.
grow up. But see, I'm learning new skills I'll take with me long after. Like bravery.
So her saying that people around her didn't want her to grow up. People around, let me do that one time. Delish. She said that people around her didn't want her to grow up. That's Vanessa Hudgens. Hi. Definitely has to be her because everybody loved her in the High School Musicals trilogy. And then, remember when she did that movie with another Disney star, Selena Gomez, where there was like Spring Breakers, I think it was called? That was horrible. Oh, that movie was atrocious. Ugh. Don't ever do that again, Vanessa. But it's Vanessa Hudgens. Okay. You are not gonna do Amy Winehouse. You are not gonna do Back to Black. When I hear Back to Black, and if you serve the way that I want you to serve tonight, I'm going to cry. I'm going to cry on my black. I'm going to cry right on my black skin. No, we're not doing this, Vanessa. You're not going to have me in my feelings tonight. But I low-key want you to, so you better kill it. Nice. Kitty, you killing me with this song. Bad. She's very comfortable tonight. And this taco gonna sit comfortably in my stomach. Nice. That was really good. Was that her best performance? Okay, Katniss Everdeen. I always wanted to learn how to do archery.
Could be Leah Michelle.
But she don't. Leah Michelle, listen. They said that last week. That is not Leah Michelle's voice. Leah Michelle, what a... Kitty did good. Teddy did really great. Kitty did really great. But Leah Michelle... would have massacred that song. Y'all be playing with Leah.
It's Night Angel's accent.
Oh, it's not real.
Maybe it's Meghan Markle.
That accent is fake.
You can call me Night Duchess from now on.
The Night Angel is from fake Pakistan. Fake Akistan. That's where she's from. Fake Akistan. Oh yeah, I said Garth Brooks a while ago. But who did Jenny say? I might want to go with what she's saying. But she's a ballerina? Okay, so... last week I said it was John Mayer because I didn't know who that guy was that sang that. Whatever, we're not going back over there. But he has children. How many children does Garth Brooks have? Let's see. Garth Brooks has 3 children. Oh, I think that's Garth Brooks. And then he got married in 1986 and divorced in 2001. But then he got married again to Trisha Yearwood. In 2005. She's a singer too. It doesn't say anything about ballet about her, but we'll see. I'ma still say Garth Brooks. We're gonna stick with you till we find out who it is, alright? Okay. I don't know this song. Oh, he's trying to win votes tonight. Rhino, you winning hearts tonight. Look like the audience is drinking it up. What is these 2 rivals in the back doing? That was nice. That was his best performance. Because he be singing good, but I don't really remember what he be saying. Okay, Rhonda, you got the people going in. Hey!
I just
want
to say.
My fave, Candy. I mean, Night Angel.
Columbia
Records. But we, you know, as I say, we know it's Candy Burris. Spring. See, Destiny's Child, because she wrote songs for them people. Is she gonna sing Donna Summer? If she's singing Donna Summer, she's singing Donna Summer, I see the disco ball. Oh no! No, you not! Y'all not gonna have me in stitches tonight. Y'all going to have tonight. No, not Donna Summer. Not the summer that was Donna's. Donna Summer.
For love.
you better. I know I don't cuss him, but you better f up Night Angel. And don't fuck it. Oh my god. Oh my god. No. No. Yes, you do. Come on, Night Angel. I want to hear them vocals. Come on. So come on, baby. Ooh. What's good? I wanted more. Night Angel, that was good. But I wanted more, and they shortened it. I would love to see the dance break and every. Listen. Listen. That was really good. But that was a teaser. Now she made me want to go listen to the song right now.
Wait, I
want to
pay it forward.
Look, wait, who said, oh baby, I think I want to marry you. Who used to sing that song? Oh, I like this song. Oh my god, no! No, 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 no. So first the kitty tried to get me in tears, then the Night Angel, now Turtle. Oh my god, this song makes me cry. And then when they, and So You Think You Dance, probably not coming back this year, but when they did that choreo to this song, where it basically was like, either it was, I don't know, I love contemporary dancing. It was like either a mother and a son or a husband and wife. And the mother or the wife, she had cancer and the son was dancing with her. It was so beautiful. And I think that was produced by Mandy Moore. You know what? Write down in the comments, I may start reacting to dance sequences. Because I love dancing. Yeah, that sounds like Jesse McCartney. When you feel so tired, but you can't sleep. Woo! You got me. You tried twice before you got me, Matt Singer. You got me crying. Father. Ooh, this song is so beautiful. This song gets me. Oh my god. This is a great episode tonight.
Lights will guide you home. And in oh my god. The, your bones. And I will try.
We're done here.
Much later.
Not doing it.
Many unbearable hours later.
Oh my god. Before we start back, my god, before we start back watching and reviewing, let's take a few minutes. Why this song really talks to me. Growing up in a different country, around people that never understood who you are, why you act the way you are, why do you think that way? They never understood that you were different, that you were made different. And this song, even though it spoke to me. It came out of a time where I was very young and spoke to me. And every time I heard it, it made me cry. Then, like I said previously, when I saw On So You Think You Can Dance, it made me even bawl even more. And now with you, Turtle, you sounding amazing like you sound, and me going back into my memory box, and then the people with the sheet doing all this, y'all just took me out. Bang! Y'all just took me out. Let me tell you about a good old cry, though. A good old cry would make you feel so good, and all the things that was happening in your life before, my heart feels like whatever was on it, whatever chains and dirt and filth and grime and weight that was on it, it feel like it's off now. My God. That's why I love singing. That's why I love dancing. That's why I love the arts. Because it takes you to places that heals you. Anyway, let's continue. That was your PSA for today. Oh my God. Woof, emotional episode. Emotional video today. Y'all getting a stripped down. Listen, every video is like y'all see more and more of who It's Me D is. And that's what we're trying to prove with this channel. Because this is who I am. All right, Angel, I love you and I do want you to win. But this one, tough. That turtle. That damn turtle. Turtle, turtle. Jesus. I'm still, oh my God, I'm still, I don't know what the heck to do with myself right now from that performance.
Once again, you murdered it. That song is such
massacre.
A song for a song.
Homicide.
A lot of when the voice
and you connecting with a song, when you connect to a song,
you can't help but feel
Brandy,
you
take it to places.
Was, my man. That's what that vocal was.
God, that song just spoke to me.
We top five, baby, we're here. It'll feel so good.
Ooh, Father.
I just want to say that you're exposing your strengths because
when a song speaks to you, when it grabs you by your spirit, that song had God in it. His vocals had God in it. That performance had God. Listen, I could go on and 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 on, but I won't.
For me, that a clue directed towards me saying that we spent the morning together.
I knew that was Jesse McCartney. I told you guys. I told you. I love my earrings go flappity floop. But I told you.
But it's the least amount of votes.
Okay.
Who must unmask and head home is
either Ryan or a Kitty. I hope it's not Kitty though.
Kitty.
Damn it! And because she was the weak. Was she the weakest tonight? No, Rhino stepped his game up. So it's just one girl.
It also had a lot of Christmas clues as well. And Vanessa's in a lot of Christmas movies too. So.
All right.
It's Vanessa.
She was a finalist and now still holds the record for the youngest selling platinum artist of all time.
Wow.
Who?
Jackie Evancho. This would you surprise and shock everyone. Why the Masked Singer?
Stereotype.
Who? 10-year-old girl. That was a shocking reveal. Oh my God. Oh my God. My God. I'm still in shock. Listen, this was the best episode ever. I was shocked by the song selection. I was shocked by who got eliminated. Oh my God, I was shocked by Rhino killing it. And now, Night Angel is the only female that's there, so she better bring it. She better bring it. Damn, nobody guessed that clue. I don't know who Jackie, who, I'm the only Jackie I know is Aunt Jackie. Jackie from, Jack A, really? Or Jackie. I know. I don't know who this person was, but it was Jackie. I don't remember the opera singer girl, Kitty. Listen, next week is the finals. We ain't gonna talk too much, but we gonna say, girl, we can't talk right now. yeah. So, Candy Burst is that night angel. If it's not Candy Burst, I don't know. Now it's like to the point, I don't know who is who anymore. What? Wow. Oh my God. Oh my God, I don't know who is who anymore. But anyway. Yeah. Who? But anyway. The Night Angel is Candy Burris. Damn, I can't put my finger on it right now. Candy Burris, that's my guess. I can't even... Bow Wow is that frog, I guess. Now, the rhino is my mailman. It could be anybody. But the rhino, I believe, is Garth Brooks. And who else is left? I'm missing one more person. Turtle. Jesse McCartney. Now I feel even more uncomfortable in saying Jesse McCartney. I still think they give them clues to the here's my thing about reality TV. I hate when they do stuff like that, or when they give like them, if it's like a reality TV show like Love & Hip Hop or Chasing Dallas, I hate when they give them a storyline. Don't give them no storyline. Let them, you know, if they're boring, they're boring. If they're interesting, then they're interesting. I don't understand it. But I think they did that to any up, you know, to get us to watch more. Or as well as to show that they wasn't really knowing who was who in under those masks. But who I think is going to be in the top two or top three, because I think they eliminate one person in the beginning of the finales. If Rhino brings it again like tonight, he might be in the top three with, it could be Rhino, Night Angel, and my mom just texted me and said, calm down. No! I told you she was gonna get me. But anyway, that I think the top three are gonna be Night Angel, Rhino, and Turtle now. Cause Rhino brought it. Rhino really brought it tonight. But I honestly think Turtle, if Turtle just keeps pushing, because Night Angel is good, but sometimes she strains her voice. And I'm here for Night Angel. If she wins, she wins. I'm here for it. But I'm telling you, that Turtle might win this. That Turtle, or if Rhino keeps bringing his game, maybe. I mean, that Rhino keeps bringing his game, maybe even Rhino. But I really believe it's Turtle. Because they love the Night Angel, but I think that Turtle is going to win. But anyway, this is my review for... I'm gonna say Love & Hip Hop. I'm so flustered. I'm like, ooh, I can't wait for the finale next week. So this has been my review, my reaction, and slight rant of The Masked Singer, season 3, episode 17, the quarterfinals. Next week is the finals, and next week I am going to do my review live on YouTube since it's the finale. So that's gonna be fun. I'm not doing StreamYard, because last time I tried, I may not do StreamYard. Unless Auntie, if you want to pop on, we could do a live review of The Masked Singer if you want. If not, I'll just do it solo dolo and just watch the comments and stuff. Either, whichever, I'm still going to do it live. But like, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you for something later. For my mama come out here and whoop my butt. Anyway, that was a great episode. Oh my goodness. Woof. Had me crying and everything.